Support TYT by shopping on Amazon through the link below.
The interview was released on the internet, and as a result, it broke all sorts of records. In fact, according to reports, the interview generated $15 million in the first 4 days. If you guys can remember, it was released on December 24th, so at this point, I'm sure it's generated a lot more. About $2.8 million in the limited theatrical run. There were a few independent movie theaters, about 300 throughout the country, that decided that they would show the interview, and they did make some money off that. And also, this would rank the film, which angered North Korea and triggered a cyber attack against the studio, as the number one online movie ever released by Sony Pictures.
So now, it's not the number one online movie of all time, period. It's released by Sony Pictures. I don't know how many they've released online like this. Obviously, it's released in very unique circumstance with a tremendous amount of accidental marketing, right? But I think the interesting part is they thought that it might have made about $20 million in the box office.
Amazing.
Right?
What are we spending our money on?
Okay. Now, but that's not overwhelming, right? Yeah. It's not a huge box office hit. They never thought it was going to be. They thought it was going to bring in about $20 million in the opening weekend. So instead, in the opening weekend, when you put $15 million online and $2.8 in the independent theaters, and you're looking at $17.8, which is kind of around $20 million. Plus, they haven't even counted Apple yet, right? Mm-hmm. iTunes began showing it on Sunday, and those numbers have not come in yet. So once they come in, it looks like they're going to be kind of where they were if they had released it in the theaters. So I'm glad to see that. That's great. And I don't like the hackers being rewarded. So here's a situation where Sony got to eventually, you know, not only have people see it, but make money off of it, because that's what they do. They make money off of movies. God bless, right? But the part that I'm amused by is all the people who've watched it, who then have come back to me and say, you know, it's not like the best movie, you know, it's just okay.
Yeah.
Of course! The act of hacking it didn't make the movie any better.
No, when you, for me, I haven't seen it yet, right? Mm-hmm. I was going to try to buy it off YouTube, and then it was this whole process, and I got deterred. But at some point, I will watch it. And it's not because I'm really curious about the movie. It's more of a political statement. It's more of celebrating freedom of expression in the country and not allowing some dictator in some other country to make decisions about what we put out there. And I don't even know whether or not Kim Jong-un was behind the hack, right? There's still a lot of questions surrounding that. But nonetheless, I like the fact that it's out there and I have the option to watch it. I remember seeing the trailer for the movie before all this controversy started, and I thought it looked like one of the dumbest movies ever. But now I'm going to watch it.
Yeah. And so just adjust your expectations. I haven't seen it yet either, but I don't expect that because there was all this controversy, it's magically going to be an awesome movie. I expect that it's going to be, you know, what it looks like. Mm-hmm. Kind of silly. There'll be a couple of funny moments in it. And at the end, you'll be like, okay, I saw it. But my point is, I will not let anybody stop me from exercising my rights as an American. My drive to watch this movie is Kim Jong Unstoppable.
At least use the self-deprecating soundboard. At least.